Welcome to Unique Shiksha. This session is specially for the interview session where we'll going to tell you how to address the aspects which has been given related to the sociology as an optional. Many students are coming from the different backgrounds, and sometimes the interview panelists, they are asking that being a student from the different background like the BTech or the MBA, management, etc., why you have chosen sociology as an optional? Well, for this you have to be very precise in nature that sociology, being studying the various aspects of the society, has attracted me. Apart from that, sociology as an optional, right from the beginning till now, has addressed various dimensions of the GS paper also. That's why it got me attracted to take sociology as an optional. Apart from this, in the sociology paper 1 and the paper 2, there are certain important topics which need to be revised before going for your interview. For example, in the paper 1, as we all know, we always talk about the thinker's part, which is quite repetitive in nature. The sociological thinkers need to be focused more today from the dynamic aspects. They are the six thinkers, out of which Emile Durkheim, Karl Marx, Max Weber, Talcott Parson, Robert King Merton, and the G.H. Mead. They have given their contribution according to their own time and according to their own perspective. But the panelists or the members, they might going to ask you which scholar you like the most and the why. For this type of the questions, you need to be very precise. Do not get into the depth of your knowledge, because then the panelist will going to take you more into the depth, and we need to evaluate that performance according to that. Hence, what we need is, you simply say, let's say Emile Durkheim is your favorite scholar, you justify it. That's how Emile Durkheim talks about the society in totality. And if we analyze his concept of the religion or the suicide, it is very much relevant from the present perspective. But it does not mean that the other scholars are not relevant. As we are talking about this thing, you have to say, sir, all other sociologists are also given their contribution, but as you have asked from my perspective, that's why I thought that for me Emile Durkheim is good in nature. Apart from the thinkers, then you can analyze the other units like the political sociology, their various ideologies, because the elections will be coming next year, so they might going to ask you something about the political aspects. In paper 2, this year lots of development has taken place regarding the law and the social change, religion, and other aspects of the society. For example, there is a triple talaq issue was there, decriminalization of the adultery has been talked about, section 377 has been addressed, then Me Too campaign is there, how the women perspective is getting more and more attraction. If every time we are talking about the women empowerment in the society, then why even till today the women empowerment bill has not been passed in the parliament? All these issues need a very clear and precise explanation from your side. Then they might going to ask you something about the role of judiciary, through which they have given the recent judgments regarding the Sabrimala case, or we talk about the judgment which is still pending about many issues. For example, let us take the perspective of the Me Too campaign. When we talk about the Me Too campaign, this positive aspect that today the women is getting more and more attention, and they are using this platform of social media to raise their voices against their male counterparts at the working place. But simultaneously, there are the negative aspects also. Some of the females, they might going to use it negatively only for their name and fame. Hence, we need to judge that whenever such types of allegations are given, or when such types of allegations are allocated on someone, then what type of approach we should take it? What type of the law should be made? How the society mentality should be changed? All these things will go into contribute in our interview approach. Then we are having another aspect regarding the religion. Now, religion we are having in India, the different religious communities. Simultaneously, the tribal people, they are practicing their own customs. Recently, one of the tribe, they attacked on the outsiders, and it was asked that why such thing has happened. When we analyze all these things, what we find that religion as a phenomena is very sensitive in nature. It is a social aspect, and time and again various aspects has came into this existence. So you might going to be asked what type of approach is required, how religion need to be analyzed, what is your viewpoint regarding our multicultural society? Do you think with the emergence of more rationality, religion will go into lose its relevance, etc. Apart from this, marriage as an institution, recently the decriminalization of the adultery has taken place. Live-in relationship is already going on. Surrogacy, adoption of the child, all these aspects are going on. Then do you think marriage as an institution is relevant at this point of time? On all these issues, you need to have a very precise and a better understanding. Sociology as a discipline is very diverse in nature, so they might going to ask you that how sociology can help you in your administration. Now, being a student of sociology, you have already studied the various institutions. So you can tell to the board members that, sir, being a student of sociology, I know already the diversity of my Indian society. Apart from this, politics, economy, marriage, family and kinship, education, etc. are the most prominent institutions in our society. So what we will going to learn, we'll going to apply that aspect in our administrative approach. And we can hope that with our sociological knowledge, we can contribute something in our administration.